We are live. Wednesday, happy Humpback Whale Day. 30 minutes of yoga. Let's get started. We only have a little bit of time, so make your way to your mat. Slide yourself across. Go ahead and get to your mat, and you're going to go ahead and wind your back. Yes, we're in this room again. The bulldog snoreth in the other room, so we must not disturb the bulldog's rest. Go ahead and lie on your back. And then just go ahead and let the soles of the feet come together. And you can bring both hands to your belly or one hand to your heart, one hand to your belly. And just take those few deep breaths to change gears. So transporting yourself from the world of responsibility you were just in to 30 minutes of just moving and breathing and focusing on yourself. Will still be there. Don't worry about it. It's all good. You got to take care of yourself first, though. A few more long breaths here. One more big inhale. Hold the breath at the top. Keep the face soft. Let the shoulders drop back. Body remains calm. And then go ahead and open up your mouth. Exhale it all out. Let yourself just drop heavy onto the mat. Good. And then you're going to bring your knees together. And you're going to go ahead and hug your knees to your chest, just nice and gentle, assuming that everybody here is cold, that you haven't done anything and warmed up beforehand. And it feels good to rock side to side, massaging yourself out. You can do that or you can stay still. But whatever you're doing, I want you to think about making a really long spine here. So instead of jutting your chin up, keep the chin down and let the crown of the head move away from your tailbone. It might mean that you're squeezing in your abdominals a little bit to do that. It might mean that your shoulders move away from the ears. But find that length, find that comfortable movement. Good. And then you're gonna go ahead and let go of your knees and you're gonna stack your knees over your hips and your ankles in line with your knees, and bring your arms out in a T-shape. You can do cactus arms if you prefer to, but I think you're gonna want T-shape, and you're gonna see why in a minute. Slowly let both knees drop over to the right-hand side, and you're gonna hover them. You're not gonna let them hang, so you're gonna keep your core engaged here, keep both shoulders on the mat, keep drawing in the navel towards the spine. So come back up to center, and then we're just gonna come to the other side and hover. So remember, draw the belly in, right shoulder comes towards the mat. Good. Keep the chin down. Try not to use your neck muscles here. Come back up to center. Drop over to the other side. Let's hover, hover, hover. Just a little bit of core work to get started. Not like yesterday. So if you tuned in yesterday, it's not going to be that. Don't worry about that. Come over to the other side. I am not without mercy. Good. Waking up here, one more. Let's hover over on the right side. Hover, hover, hover. Draw the belly in. Shoulders flat on the mat. Draw up through center. Off to the left side. Hover, hover, hover. Pull the belly button in. Good. Coming back up. Now we're going to come all the way over to the right side. Let those knees fall and just get a big twist here. Just a big, sloppy, loose twist. Doesn't have to be pretty. You can turn your gaze over your left shoulder. Wave. Hi. Good. Come back up through center. Let those knees fall over to the left-hand side. Option to turn the gaze over the right shoulder. You can wave to whatever is over there if you want. You can wave to nothing. You can wave or not wave. It's your choice. Then when I come back to center, you're going to hook your hands underneath your knees, and you're going to slowly roll up and roll back. Roll up. And roll back. So we're not coming all the way up here. We're just rolling and stopping on our seat, using our abs to control the movement. And if it feels a little bit uncontrolled, that's okay. That's why you do this. You practice. It was a practice. Okay, let's do this one more time. We're going to roll, come back up, and stop. Good. Now, you can keep your hands underneath your knees. You can reach your arms forward, or if you want, you don't want to bring your hands behind you. But find some place that feels right. I want you to keep your toes level with your eyes and don't throw the chin up. Keep the chin nice and in alignment so that your neck is nice and long here. So it's not down on your chest, it's not up in the sky. It's just, you're looking at your toes.
Hopefully you can get a pedicure soon. Good. And then you're going to come halfway down floating. I have to keep the knees bent because there's an arm bar here. I can go back. Float down and then come back up. Good. Go ahead and cross your ankles. Roll forward. You're going to plant the palms and step right back into down dog here. And so if you want, you can twist side to side. If you want, you can bend the knees right and left. Just kind of find those little movements that feel organic to you. You can even do little kind of frog jumps here. But play with it, you know, something, if your brain's telling you to do something, like give it a try. As long as it's not dangerous, you're good. So press into your fingertips so we have that weight nice and evenly distributed through the whole of the hand. Wrap your triceps in, let your head drop. Good. Inhale your right leg up to the sky. Exhale, left ankle relaxes. Now bend your right knee and stack your right hip over your left. Push your right foot away from you, but keep the left hip pushing back too so you're not collapsing your entire left side. Good. Square the hips, straighten the leg. And then you're going to slide forward into plank and you're going to bring your right knee towards your right tricep. Good. Inhale up. Bend and open. Inhale, reach with the right leg. Exhale, right knee to left tricep. Good. Inhale, reach. Exhale, bend and open. Inhale, reach. Exhale, knee to nose. Good. Tuck into a tight little ball here. And then you're going to plant your right foot between your hands. And so your right foot's on the right railroad track, your left foot's on the left railroad track, fingertips at your sides. Or you can come onto your fist, or you can come on flat palms. It's really up to you. Inhale, straighten leg. Exhale, bend the knee, sinking. Good. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, sink. Inhale, straighten. Exhale, sink and hold. You're going to turn your back left foot flat. You're going to turn your toes, your right toes in. Keep the right knee bent. So now we're kind of a side lunge here, right knee bent, left leg straight. And then we're going to come over to the left-hand side, bending the left knee. Good, walk back over to the right. Walk back over to the left. Walk back over to the right. One more time, stay low if you can. To the left, to the right. Right knee is bent. We're gonna walk our hands forward and away from us, finding those down dog arms and let the head drop here. Good, keep the shoulders moving away from the ears. Keep pulling your right hip under you. Good. Stay with that sensation. Sensation is a euphemism for what you probably feel on your right side. Good. Start to walk your hands back. We're still at this angle with our torso. Left hand comes underneath your left shoulder. Rotate the right arm up for, to the sky. Good. And then both hands come down as we start to walk back towards the front of the mat. Inhale the right leg up to the sky. And then right leg comes down. Opposite side, that left leg is gonna come up. I want you to flex that left foot. Exhale, relax the right ankle. Push the mat away from you. Bend the left knee. Pop the left hip over right. So remember, we want that right hip to keep moving back, and we're gonna keep our shoulders square so the rotation's only coming from this left hip. Good. Reach the left leg, straightening the hips, and then you're gonna bring the left knee towards the left tricep. Good. Inhale up. Exhale, bend and open up the hips. Inhale, straighten the leg. Exhale, left knee, right tricep. Good. Inhale, reach. Exhale, bend. Inhale, reach. Exhale, bring the knee to the nose. Tuck, tuck, tuck. And then plant that left foot down. Remember the railroad tracks. Left foot's on the left railroad track. Right foot's on the right railroad track. Hands on either side. Fist, fingertips, flat palms, your choice. We are going to inhale, straighten the left leg, fold over it. Exhale, bend the knees, sink. Inhale, come up. Exhale, down. Inhale, come up. Exhale, down. You're going to turn your left toes in. You're going to turn your back right foot flat. I'm going to turn so you guys can see me. So we have our bent left knee and our straight right leg, and we're turned towards the side of our mat and start to walk over towards the right side, and then back to the front. Remember, we're trying to stay low here. And then to the back, and then to the front. Let's do it again, to the back, to the front and hold, Keep this angle. Walk those hands out. Find those down dog arms. Let the head drop. Shoulders away from the ears. Pull that left hip under you. Finding the sensation we experienced on the right side, on the left side. Yes. Getting warm nice and quick. Walk the hands back towards you. Right hand comes directly underneath the right shoulder. Turn the left shoulder, the left hand up to the sky. Good. And then bring both hands down. Start to walk back onto your mat, finding your lunge. Plant the hands and then sweep that left leg up to the sky. Left leg comes down to meet the right. Take a big breath in. And then exhale, you can walk your feet forward towards your hands. Good. And then just hang here for a minute. Let your head drop. You can sway. You can grab opposite elbows. But just really let your head drop, let the torso get heavy. And think about internally rotating your thighs here. Good. And that'll help the crown of the head extend further towards the mat. Good. Grab your big toes with your peace fingers and thumbs. Inhale, look forward, exhale, bow, and you can let the elbows come out. So you can use your grip to gently guide you down, but I'd rather you really kind of use the muscles of your core and that internal rotation of your thighs to help create more length through your torso, more length with the hips lifting, and then those elbows come out to help the shoulders slide up the back away from the ears. So try to do it without yanking yourself down, in other words. Good, and then relax. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, hands to hips. Inhale, come all the way up. Good, good, good. Inhale, the arms up and overhead. And then exhale, swan dive down. We're gonna go through a Surya A. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, plant the palms. Step back to high plank. Come down, chaturanga, elbows kiss the ribs. Inhale, up dog, roll those shoulders back. Good, lift the chin, press into your toes. Exhale, press back, down dog. Big breath in. Exhale, step or jump the feet to the hands. Inhale, look forward, flat back, pull the hips over the ankles. Exhale, down. Here we go, reverse swan dive. Inhale, up, up, up. Let's go through one more. Exhale, all the way down. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, step or jump back. High plank. Come down, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, press that down dog. Big breath in through the nose. Exhale, step the feet forward. Inhale, lengthen, looking forward. Exhale, belly in as you bow. Here we come all the way up, up, up. Hands meet. Exhale, draw the hands through heart center. Good, continuing. We're gonna bend the knees, sit back, get nice and low into chair pose. And so in your chair pose, I want you to really squeeze the legs together. Good. Get nice and tight here. Reach the arms forward, and you're sitting back, but you're lifting the chest up. So try not to dump into your lumbar spine here. You wanna kinda turn the tailbone down somewhat so that you're bringing the space between the ribs and the hips a little bit closer. All right, you're gonna ground into your right leg. Keep reaching forward, tap the left foot back. Tap it forward. Tap it back. Tap it forward. Tap it back. Tap it forward. Last time, tap it back, and then bring the torso upright and find your lunge. Good, find your steady here. Keep pushing the left heel back and the right knee forward. If you need to bend that left knee to not compromise your posture here by keeping the ribs above the hips, bend the left knee. It's all good. Arms up and overhead. Hands come down. You can step straight back to down dog, or you can do an optional vinyasa. It's just whatever you want today. Good. Big breath in through the nose. Exhale, step the feet forward. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, bow. Let's come all the way up, 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 hands meet. Exhale, drop through heart center. Chair pose again. Bend the knees, sit nice and low. Good, so remember we're squeezing the legs together. We're zipping up all the way from our feet, through our hips, through our obliques, up to our fingertips. Good. Keep leaning forward. This time we're gonna tap the right leg back and tap it forward. So find that steady with the left leg. Tap right foot back, Tap forward. You might find one side likes this side, likes this little trick more than the other. Tap it forward. Tap it back and hold. Arms up and overhead. So play with your lunge here. Do you want to bend that knee or do you want to push that heel back? What feels right today? Keep reaching energy all the way up through the fingertips. Good. Big breath in. Exhale, hands come down. Step back, down dog, or optional vinyasa. And everybody meets in down dog. Good. Big breath in through the nose. Exhale, step the feet forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, bow. Good. Swan dive all the way up, hands meet. Exhale, draw through heart center. Come into chair pose once more. So we've been here before. Squatting into our chair pose. Good, staying really strong through our legs. Tucking in the belly. Energy comes into the right leg. Let's do those taps again. Tap back once and forward. Twice and forward. Three times, forward. And then on the fourth time, we come back to our lunge. All right? All familiar territory. Okay. You're going to bring your hands to your heart in prayer. Left elbow is going to come to the outside of the right knee. Good. So we're going to use our core to find the rotation. We're not going to crank ourselves with our elbows. So we're going to bring that elbow outside the knee, push the palms together, helping find the rotation. So now is that left leg jumping down, or are you staying strong through the left leg, lifting that thigh? Good. Press the palms together. Excellent. Go ahead and reach the arms out. Big, big stretch here. Good. Bring them back to prayer. And then you're going to look down. Bring both hands down. Step back. Down dog. I'm sorry. Down dog or vinyasa. No, down dog was right. I don't know. Everybody needs a down dog. Big breath in. Exhale. Step the feet forward. Inhale. Look forward. Exhale. Bow. Let's reverse them all the way up. Hands meet, drop your heart center. Find our chair pose once more. Get nice and low. Good, so reaching strong forward with our fingertips, squatting into our chair pose. Put all that energy into that left leg as you tap back once and forward. Twice, forward, three times, forward. Now the fourth time we come up to our lunge. I'm gonna turn, good. So we're going to bring the hands to the heart in prayer. Remember that twist we did on the left side, we're going to do here. So that right elbow is going to come to the outside of the left knee. Find that rotation, press the palms together. Keep pressing through the right leg. Good. Option to reach right arm down and left arm up. Good. Stay strong here. Can you open up your chest more? Can you soften and gaze? If you can't, it's okay. But try. Good. Go ahead and bring the hands back to the heart in prayer. You're going to look down. Go ahead and bring the hands down. Step back. Down dog or vinyasa. Everybody meets in down dog. You stay where you are. I'm going to turn around again. Good. From down dog, step the feet forward. Inhale. Exhale, bow. Let's reverse all the way up. Hands meet. Drop through heart center. Chair pose once more. Last round. Reach strong forward. Put that energy into the right leg. Tap back once and forward. Twice. Forward. Three times. Forward. Fourth time. Come up into your lunge. Draw the belly in. Good. Hands come to the heart in prayer. Left elbow, right knee. Good. Keep pressing the palms together. Cheer myself off. Left arm down, right arm up. Good. Keep reaching. Puffing out the chest, bringing the shoulder blades together. Good. Start to pull yourself up with your right hand. Big twist, right hand to the left thigh. Left arm reaches back. So your left leg is back, your right hand is touching the back of your left leg. Your right knee is forward and your left arm reaches up and back. Reach forward, right arm back. So we're in this twist. Hands come to the heart. We're going to bring that left elbow to the outside of the right knee. Look down at your feet. We're going to tap again. So tap the left foot forward and back. Forward and back. Forward and back. Last time, brings both feet together. Inhale the arms up and overhead. Exhale, bow down. Optional vinyasa here. Or you can stay in your forward folding bend and come out of that leg. Good. And then coming back to the top of the mat, everybody in forward folding bend, inhale, look forward, exhale, bow. Let's reverse all the way up, up, up. Draw the hands through heart center. I'm gonna turn, bend the knees, get nice and low. Chair pose. Good. Remember that energy in the left leg. Keep reaching forward with the arms. Tap back once, right foot, forward. Twice, forward. Three times, forward. Fourth time, hold the lunge. Kaboom. Hands come to the heart in prayer. Right elbow, left knee. Find your twist. Excellent. Right hand, left arm. Twist. All right, so that left arm waving up here, it's gonna pull us up. So pull yourself up. Left arm reaches back, right arm reaches forward. Rotating into your lunge. Left hand, right thigh, right arm comes up and overhead, big twist. Good. Reaching. Good. Right arm forward, left arm back. Hands come to the heart in prayer. Right elbow, left knee. Get ready to tap. I know that left leg is burning. Kind of point. So look down, tap once, back. Twice, back. Three times, back. Fourth time, hold it. Inhale, arms up and overhead. Exhale, bow. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step back. You can go straight to down dog, or you can go through vinyasa. It's your choice. Your choice, your choice, your choice. Good. Take a big breath in here. Exhale it out. One more. Inhale. Exhale it out. Step the right foot forward. Come up into a lunge. All right? So we're in our high lunge here. We're going to cross our right arm underneath our left arm. Gerudo arms. We're going to come into full eagle pose. So you can do it in a few steps. You can do it in one step. We're gonna bring the left leg over the right. So we're gonna start to bring the left leg forward, crossing the legs, and then sitting down. Now you can use those left toes as a kickstand, or you can wrap those left toes around that right calf. Sink into it, and I'd rather you sit low than drop your chest forward. So sit low, good. And then undo the twist, step back into your lunge, arms up and overhead, hands down, set back down dog, take a big breath in, exhale out, good, one more, inhale in, exhale out, excellent, step the left foot forward, come up into the high lunge, opposite side, all right, so right elbow is going to come underneath left, find a rep, your elbows forward and up, that right leg is going to come over the left leg. So one, two, three, or 10 steps, whatever it takes. Take a breath, you've got this. We're gonna bring that right leg over, cross, and sit low. Good. So you can use your right toes to kickstand, or you can start with the kickstand and then wrap deeper. Keep sitting back, keep lifting the chest. Don't throw your torso forward. I want you to keep the strength. We're gonna use that word for it, the strength in your legs. Feels like jelly, but hey, we'll call it strength. Go ahead and straighten the leg, step back into the lunge. Arms up and overhead. Hands come down, step back down dog. Big breath in, exhale and out. Good. Step your right foot forward, walk your hands over to the left so your hands stop in the middle of the mat and your feet are parallel. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, bow down. Good. Bring your hands directly underneath your shoulders, and you can press gently into your hands as if you were going to slide your hands forward, but they're not moving, to help come into the forward folding bend a little bit deeper. Now when you're here, I want you to activate your thighs. So it feels kind of like your quadriceps are going up your thighs. You're activating your quadriceps and internally rotating your thighs. It's a little bit more challenging to feel that sensation with the wide-legged forward bend than with our legs close together. But see if you can find it. And if you can't, it's okay. You have something to look forward to. Inhale, look forward. And then you're going to start to walk towards the front of the mat. Step back. Find your plank pose. Come all the way down onto the mat. Your feet are flat, hands underneath the shoulders. Roll the shoulders back. Inhale, cobra. Good, keep the elbows in. Keep pushing them down. Come all the way down. Take a big breath in. Exhale it out. Good. Walk your hands back by either side of your rib cage. Roll your shoulders back. Press yourself up into a modified cobra here. Good. Now we're keeping the hips on the mat. You could go higher, but we're going to keep the hips on the mat. Then come all the way down. Big breath in. Exhale it out. Hands under the shoulders. Press back to child's pose. Just feel the length in the lower back here. You can keep your arms forward. You can bring them to your sides. It's up to you. Good. And then bring your hands underneath your shoulders. Press your torso up off of your thighs. Now, you're welcome to sit in hero's pose like this. If that's really uncomfortable, you can find a block to sit on, or you can sit in an easy seated pose, but we're just gonna get into the shoulders really quickly. All right, you're gonna bring your right arm across you and draw the right arm towards you. So you've probably done this once or twice before. This is not news. I'm gonna come to hero's pose because it's just comfortable for me. All right, so we're gonna keep this right arm straight. We're gonna reach both arms forward and have the palms touch each other. Now, as they press each other, I want you to push your shoulders forward and bring your chin to your chest. Good, get a big stretch between the shoulder blades here. Good, you can go ahead and lift the chin. Keep this crossing of the wrists and bring the arms up and overhead. And I want you to press those palms together with the shoulders coming down the back. Excellent. You hear a bulldog. Now you're gonna bend your right elbow, reach your right hand behind you. Left hand is going to gently draw your right elbow in to get a little bit more of a stretch through the tricep. Good. And then go ahead and release, give it a shake. Opposite side. Left arm comes across. Use the right arm to draw the left arm towards you. Keep the shoulders down. Try not to shrug them here. If you're shrugging them, back off a little bit. Keep the left arm straight. We're going to straighten both arms forward and then reverse the palms so they press towards one another. Tuck the chin towards the chest. Roll the shoulders forward. Create that little arch in the back here, in the upper back. Get a big stretch. And then lift the chin, keeping that press of the palms. Arms come up and overhead. Shoulders come down the back. Keep pressing the palms together, just really active. Good. And then left elbow's gonna bend, left hand reaches behind you, right hand gently guides the left elbow in to get a bigger stretch through the left tricep. Good. Release, give it a shake. Good. Drop your hips to either side, or if your legs are crossed, go ahead and straighten your legs before you. Press the legs forward, inhale, arms up and overhead. Exhale, out and over. Good, to the forward folding bend. Keep pressing the legs into the mat. Keep drawing the crown of the head towards your toes. Inhale, arms up. Exhale them down. Go ahead and bring the legs wide. Wide-legged forward bend. And so you want to get the legs as wide as you can go, where you can still sit up on your own. And then walk your arms forward and just rest here. So this is my max. If you're one of those cool people who can bring your chest all the way down to the mat, you're awesome. Can't do it. But I think it's cool that you can. I would love to be able to do that. I don't think that's ever been in my range of motion, ever. And I'm not that kind of person who's just going to spend my entire life trying to get access to one posture. It just doesn't make sense to me. I do this because I want to move. So there. Good. Start to walk the hands back towards you. Bring your hands behind you. You need to slide the legs together. Give them a shake. And when you're on your mat, you might want to bring your seat down if you've gotten too far up, just so you've got a place for your head to land. When we slowly and carefully lower ourselves all the way down onto the mat, Good, bring the feet as wide as the mat, outer edges of the feet line up with the outer edge of the mat, drop both knees over to the right. Come through center, drop both knees over to the left. Come through center, give yourself a little hug, draw the knees in. You can bring your forehead towards your knees if you want. Then lie down, let the feet come down. Let the legs stretch, arms to your sides. And just let it go. So you are welcome to stay here for as long as you like. Or else if you have work or someplace else to go, then you can go do that. But thanks for joining me. Go forth and be awesome. Bye.